This is Mike J. Welcome back to the channel. What I want to talk about here today is we all know that used car prices here in the last few months, or actually for a while, has shot up in value. A lot of car dealerships right now are not buying a lot of cars from auctions like Manheim due to the fact that the cars are costing so much now to buy, and to put it on their lots, they've got to make a profit and they have to mark them up, which makes them very expensive to put on the lots. And not a lot of people are really trading their cars in. So that puts me to this point of saying, well, let's check out a few cars and see what the market is. And it's something that I already knew for a while, but the C7 Corvette, like what I have up top there, 17, 18, 19 model years, have shot up in value. I booked my car out on KBB.com, KellyBlueBook.com, and this car right here, being that it's a 1LT base FET with 2,000 miles on it, still brings in, on trade-in, around $45,000. The low on this car is $43,000. One of my friends that work at a car dealership has also said that yes, the C7s had gone up in value as far as retail cash or if you want to trade it in. And those of you that do follow YouTube, you must know the YouTuber Mike Davenport called the ChevyDude. He has his own YouTube channel and he is a car salesman for a Chevrolet dealership in Louisville, Kentucky. And he had a Q&A video live chat the other day and he happened to answer one of my comments on there asking him about the C7 with my car on what it's worth. And he was right on the money. As far as trade-in, buying it out from you, $45,000 for this C7 Corvette. And it still retails for $50,000. The reason why these vets, the C7, has gone up a lot in value is due to the fact that there is no C8 Corvettes to sell. The wait for them is at least 18 months to 2 years before you will see a C8 Corvette that you can go in and buy at MSRP. So you can forget about a discount, because right now the C8 Corvettes are bringing in a minimum of $20,000 over sticker if you want one. So what are people doing? They're buying up the C7s, like 17, 18, 19 model year. And just to put in comparison, in 2018 model year for the C7 Corvettes, they only made 5,000 of them. Now, I don't know why they made so little. Maybe they didn't anticipate sales because of the new one coming out. Nevertheless, they only made 5,000 of these 18 C7 Corvettes. So there isn't that many out there. And I guess people are looking for the old C7s because probably they want a transmission that's manual. Who knows? But all I know is that right now, if you own a C7 Corvette within a few years with low mileage, the car is probably worth quite a bit of money. Yes, you are going to lose some money on it considering what you bought it for. But this is the thing. When I bought this car, it was a car that was left over, that was on the floor for at least 14 months. And I'm, pretty much tell it how it is. I paid $47,000 for this Corvette. So if I sell it for $45,000 cash money, I didn't lose anything. If I trade this car in, here in the state of Arizona, you only pay sales tax on the difference of the car. So therefore, that's about a $3,000 gain, right? So that means I made $1,000 off this car if I was to trade it in. So those of you that do have a C7, if you're thinking about contemplating about selling it because you're waiting for the new one, and you never know what the futures of these cars are going to do, they could go the opposite way and drop in value. But I don't foresee that happening until the C8s are going to be flooded on the dealership floors. And that's going to be at least 18 months to 2 years before that ever happens. But it's a thought, I've got three cars here that I can't possibly drive, this one driver and three vehicles. So What I might do is, I don't know what I want to do, that's the problem, but I will probably end up selling it or trading it for something, but I just can't part with it because it doesn't have a lot of miles. But like I said, to park, you know, a vehicle like this that's worth some money and just let it sit, it could turn the opposite way. Just like houses in the United States, you know, and throughout some parts of the, you know, other countries, houses have gone up a lot and shot up a lot in value. Like here in Arizona, houses have gone up like crazy. It could go in the opposite way when the forbearance ends. Who really knows? But at this time right now, houses and cars bring in a lot of money. And especially if you own a C7 Corvette, and if you're thinking about selling, you're thinking about trading, there is no better time than to do it right now and get the most money as you can and figure out what you want to do. And if you do want to order a C8, you know, you could do that, and at least you're going to get some money out of your vet while you're waiting for the new one. But anyways, a shout out to the Chevy dude, Mike Davenport, at Louisville, Kentucky, at a Chevrolet dealership. And book your vet out and see what it's worth. Or better yet, just book your car out if you're thinking about selling any car. You would be surprised that the values on used cars have gone up quite a bit. But anyways, if you like this video, please give me a big thumbs up. Please like, subscribe, comment. Tap the notification bell for future videos. And I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.